Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about Tesla's 0 to 60 time of 2.28 seconds as measured by Motor Trend. Now shortly after publishing that video, Jason Cammisa and Frank Markus of Motor Trend reached out to me and they said, hey, the reason why your theoretical limit of 0 to 60 in 2.32 seconds is actually slower than our measured time of 2.28 seconds is because you are not including the amount of time it takes for 1 foot of rollout. And so they actually write all this in their article. I should have fully read it before, you know, publishing a video on it. But regardless, it's something I want to talk about here and talk about how rollout works, why the industry uses it, and how impressive this P100D actually is, regardless of which number we're looking at, 2.53 versus 2.58. So what is rollout? Well, if you take your car to a drag strip, you may have already known what this is. So basically what happens is there's going to be two light beams going across that track. You're going to have the pre-stage beam, and then you're going to have the stage beam. So as you're inching up to that start line of that drag strip, you're going to hit the pre-stage beam, and that's going to let you know that you're 7 inches away from the stage beam. So slow down, inch up very carefully until you hit that stage beam. Then you're going to continue to roll your car up until you hit that stage beam. There'll be a light that lets you know, hey, you're staged, you're in the right spot, don't move, and wait for the Christmas tree to go down so you know when to start your race. So where this 1 foot number came from, once the lights tell you to go, what's going to happen is you're going to start moving and the clock does not start until this stage beam is no longer pointing on your tire. So once there's a clear path for this stage beam, that's when it starts the clock. So your tire is going to start to roll, you're going to continue to move, and so you're already moving and this stage beam is still pointing on your tire until you leave it completely once you get to this position here. And that's when the clock starts. And so this distance right here is that rollout. That's basically free time because the stage beam hasn't started the clock yet and yet you're moving. And so typically this ends up being about 1 foot. You get up to about 3 miles per hour and it gives you about a 0.3 second advantage in your 0 to 60 time. Now, as you can imagine, the rollout of a vehicle can vary. And so there's two major factors that can change this. The first being the diameter of the tire. So if you were to have a smaller tire, it would roll off of this stage beam sooner and the overall distance that it traveled would be shorter. So a smaller tire will give you less of a rollout advantage. A larger tire will give you more of a rollout advantage. Also, the initial position matters. So if you roll up to the drag strip and you come just right when you get onto that stage beam and you stop, then you're going to have more of an advantage than if you were to roll a little bit further and have less distance to travel before that clock starts. So what the industry decided to do to normalize all of this is just decide that every vehicle will get the first foot free. You don't measure that first foot of travel distance, and so that keeps it consistent among everyone. So the reason why all of the major auto journalists are going to use this, whether it's Motor Trend, Road and Track, Car and Driver, whoever, they're all going to be using this 1 foot of rollout and excluding that from their 0 to 60 time, partly to, you know, remain consistent with the NHRA, which, you know, is basically the top tier of drag racing out there. Partly because if you take your car to a drag strip, that's the number that you're going to be able to get, so you can measure it directly with the car magazine. And then also, it's done to remain consistent with historical data. So nowadays, we can do all of this with GPS, and you can get the true 0 to 60 time very easily. And so many of the magazines will include, you know, both numbers for you to look at, just so you know. But they're going to give you that subtraction of 1 foot of rollout simply to remain consistent with all of history. So if you go back and look at something in the 1960s and compare it with something from today, you can compare, you know, oranges to oranges or apples to apples. I don't think many people say oranges to oranges, but the point is you can compare those directly and that will give you, you know, something meaningful rather than if we switched everything today and then you went back and looked, it wouldn't be a direct comparison. So it's kind of silly to include it nowadays, but thankfully a lot of the magazines will give you both numbers as Motor Trend did in their article on this. And so the important thing is that you can look at either or. But when I was calculating my theoretical limit, which was 2.32 seconds, that was assuming the full duration from a stop to 60 miles per hour. So what did the P100 actually do in this? Well, they were actually able to cross that 1 foot in just 0.26 seconds, a little bit quicker than 0.3, which is kind of an average for cars out there. They were able to accelerate all the way up to 5.9 miles per hour in that first foot. and they were able to achieve, if you include that rollout, a 0 to 60 of 2.53 seconds. Now this number is still actually really cool, and here's why. Their stopping distance for this exact same car from 60 to 0 was 2.48 seconds. So if you look at that versus the 0 to 60, it's a difference of 1/20th of a second between accelerating and decelerating. So basically the car can stop just as fast, or I should say the car can accelerate just as fast as the car can stop, which basically does not happen. I mean, there aren't other cars out there that can do this. So it's a very unique thing about this Tesla P100D. We'll probably get more of these vehicles in the future. Part of it's the fact that it's electric. There's no gear shifts. You get instant torque. Honestly, this thing's not going to be using all of its torque until it gets to maybe 30, 40 miles per hour, because otherwise you're just going to sit there spinning the tires. So it's got plenty of torque, no gear shifts. Kind of gives you the perfect scenario of, you know, accelerating from 0 to 60. Just in that last bit, you know, from maybe 50 to 60 miles per hour, it doesn't quite have the power to fully put down all of the grip that it has. And so it has a slightly better braking time than its accelerating time. But for all intents and purposes, I mean, they are basically the same. So very cool. It's able to accelerate at an average of 1.0 G. Across the 0 to 60 range, and it's able to decelerate an average of 1.1 Gs. Super cool. Now, in my other video, I compared it to the P85, not the P85D, just the regular P85, which was able to stop in just 102 feet. And there are some certain reasons for that, but basically that gives it a deceleration of 1.18 G, and that's where I came up with my theoretical 0 to 60 limit for the Tesla based on the grip of this P85 at 2.32 seconds that it would be able to accelerate in. So if you were to look at this vehicle here compared to the P100D, though, there are some major differences. 4,633 pounds versus 4,891 pounds. So about a 250 pound difference between the P85 versus the P100D. It doesn't have that all-wheel drive system, so it doesn't have the two motors up front. And also has a better weight distribution for braking. 4753 versus 5149. So it's going to have a more even load under braking and be able to decelerate quicker than the P100D. So a theoretical 0 to 60, you know, what's the fastest time we'll ever see a Tesla P100D accelerate based on today's current street tire technology? We're not talking about race car tires. A lot of people like to jump in the comments and, you know, talk about, you know, top fuel at 0.8 seconds, 0 to 60, things like that. That's on a completely different tire. We're talking street legal tires here. Based on the grip that it has in deceleration, you could expect to see a 0 to 60 of 2.3 seconds, including that 1 foot of rollout time, or if you're excluding that 1 foot of rollout time, as low as 2.1 seconds, assuming a perfect world. Now, this is kind of strange to say because this doesn't have motors up front, so it's going to have more weight and it's going to have a different weight distribution. So just based on its grip, on the grip of those tires, and assuming that you can have that grip for acceleration, you could potentially see a 2.1 0 to 60 time versus the 2.28, which we saw in the P100D. So very cool. We're basically just coming down to the limit of grip now, which is cool that, you know, technology has gotten there. It's really, everything is dependent on tires these days. You know, if there are tires that are street legal and come out that have more grip than our current tire technology, then we will see these 0 to 60 times improve. If they don't, then they're kind of gonna, you know, taper off here at this limit. So thank you guys for watching. Certainly recommend checking out the other video that I posted on this. If you have not yet, it goes way into the detail. It goes into way more detail on all of the math behind all of this. So worth checking out. Thank you guys for watching. Any questions or comments, leave them below.